We're back. We heard there was a new scammer in town. More Chinese folk targeting poor innocent folding knives. Well, not on our watch. Seen too much clowning and scamming going on lately, and seeing no government doing nothing about it. It's up to us, the DBK boys, / warriors, / legends, / dragon fighters, to take this on and expose the wrongdoers. Wrongdoers.
Oh damn, it's a scam.
Wow, what a great giveaway.
It's the Falcon Even F1X, the S1X, and the A1X. Yeah, that's almost $1,000 that we're giving away right to you guys.
This is crazy.
Three winners.
You see these two knives, eh? Benchmade. Bugout, one of the most popular folding knives.
And yes. There had to be another scammer.
When it's popular, you get scams.
And not... It's not been done, my English, nice. It's not been done enough about it. So yep. Now it's up to the DBK heroes to save y'all.
Bought the clone at Wish for 13 euros.
That's a really good deal.
That's a really good deal,
Martin.
Seems like a very good deal. Well, oh, it looks like the real deal, but is it the real deal? We're gonna
step it up a notch every test to see how far it can go compared to the real ones.
Yoopy-dooby-doo.
Yeah, there are a lot of differences, actually. Look at the flags. The color. The font. Oh, the release knob is not that great finish. The coating is different. The swedge is different. It feels different when it opens. The lock locks the knife less good. The grip pattern is different. Their overall finish is worse because look at all those little lines that are not finished. The packaging is different. The nylon bag is different. The sharpening notch is different. The screws stick out everywhere. Begin with the retention test. Hey.
Fake one.
Is it sharp?
It is sharp.
Real Benchmade?
Real Benchmade. Ropey.
Fake!
Yes, it's one big roll. Light betoning, and look, it's rapid fire skill, if you want to know. He's a little step further. You see it on camera?
Gast. Yeah, you can see that very clearly.
Okay, that's this fake one. Let me try the real one. Oh, nothing at all. Nothing at all. No wiggle at all. No wiggle. No wiggle at all, bitches.
Hey! Martin!
That is dangerous.
That's a short video.
Nice.
Wait.
But we should do this with the original as well. Fair is fair.
Oh, that was so far harder! Holy shit!
Okay, let's see if it has wiggle.
Look at this. Look at how deep it went. Okay.
But what I don't understand is that, okay, the other one is a fake. But this one has also just got plastic and just a
look
thin
at this
piece of steel.
Still no wiggle.
Nothing.
Nothing.
I'm not an expert in steel and plastic, but this both looks very thin. So I don't get how this managed it so easily and this... Oh my god. This is more amazing than I thought.
And that's why we make... Oh damn, it's a scam.
Oh damn, it's a bloody scam.
Well, that went as expected. Whoa, did you know you can win the Velgrieven F1X and the S1X and the A1X? This is the last week. It's the last week of the giveaway. And if you subscribe to our Patreon for the $10, I think it's $12 now, not our fault, Patreon's fault, then you win the knife. Three winners.
Yeah.
And thank you, Blade HQ, for support, for giving us the A1X for the giveaway. Nice.
Blade HQ!
The knives. Well, there are only two knives left. That's because one died.
Hey. I was actually amazed how bad this clone was.
Yeah, but I was also amazed how kind of identical it looked to the real deal.
Yeah.
Until you looked at closer at it, you kept noticing more and more differences.
Yeah, it was. It's completely in another league. And what I found very interesting is that normally you would have a little thing called diminishing return come into place. And so I could expect that this knife would be like maybe 60% of the real knife.
Yeah.
And that would be still a very big scam.
Yeah.
But it was like maybe 2% or something.
It was even with feather sticking, I felt how flexible it was. It was just crazy. But I mean, I didn't expect this knife to survive lost test, and it did. It really amazed us, just like the Benchmade did with the Freak. It also really surprised us. But they call this knife the Bug Out. This is an amazing EDC knife. It is light. It is, you don't feel it in your pocket. It slices like a laser. But I would, for Bug Out tasks, I would probably take the Freak. But it doesn't mean that this knife isn't amazing, because this knife is bloody amazing.
Yeah.
This is my go-to EDC knife at the moment. If you buy this, make sure just to buy it at a known retailer of a Benchmade. Don't go shopping at some Chinese site for a Benchmade. If you get somebody that says, hey, you want to buy my Bug Out? Take it. If it has that flex. If it is...
Yeah.
If you cannot let the skills touch each other, then it's a real deal.
Lion Steel.
Lion Steel, yes.
A Lion Steel secret.
And pizza.
Do you know what's coming as well? Can we get a knife?